let's get rolling because we've got a crap ton to go through. Hello, inhabitants of the World Wide Web, how's life? If you know anything about me, you'll know that I'm completely obsessed about anything Disney related. And it's not just your normal healthy obsession. Oh no. I'm talking about how I've practically dedicated most of my life to learning about Disney and knowing as much as I can about the subject. I don't just go to Disney World, oh no, I go home. And when I found out that there were people out there who didn't know as much about Disney as I did, I felt sad for them. Because they're missing out. This is what your Disney education is for. So, I am gonna go through the biggest and best Disney films out there to begin with and impart some of my wisdom onto you. So you can no longer be clueless and rat your friends at Disney trivia. Today's video is going to be dedicated to Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs, the very first feature-length film to come out of Walt Disney Studios. Development on Snow White began in the early months of 1934 until its official announcement in June 1934. I think it would be safe to say that a lot of people were a bit apprehensive about this film being released because Disney had had a reputation already for making short films about a little mouse in shorts. And with a budget of $250,000 to its name, in December 1937, Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs was premiered at the Carthay Circle Theatre in LA. And pretty much the film was a hit from the minute it started captivating the audiences, even receiving a standing ovation at the end. At the 11th Academy Awards, Snow White received an Academy Honorary Award, and Mr. Disney himself received a full-size Oscar statuette that was accompanied by seven little statuettes to represent Snow White and her seven dwarfs. I'm going to talk about the story now. I'm not going to go into too much detail because I know that there are some people out there who have seen the film, so there would be no point in going into complete detail about Snow White when you can just go out and watch it yourself. But you've got Snow White, the prettiest woman in the entire land, and is on the receiving end of a lot of hatred from an incredibly jealous woman. Her stepmother, the Queen. The Queen wants to be fairest of them all, but because Snow White exists, she can. So the Queen hires a huntsman to kill her stepdaughter. The huntsman takes Snow White into the forest and is about to kill her when his conscience rocks up like, "Hi, this is a young woman you're about to kill. Are you really gonna go through with it?" So he reveals his employer's intentions to a completely terrified Snow White and orders her to run away from the kingdom and save herself. Snow White, of course, makes a run for it, and what follows is a pretty scary forest scene. That scared the crap out of me when I was a kid. And that's the thing that you'll find out throughout all of the early Disney films. There are parts in each film that absolutely terrified children, or mostly me. I will put my hand up and say that mostly Disney terrified me when I was a child. Why do I love it? It emotionally scarred me for life. No, seriously, Dumbo did, and you'll find out why. The animation in this scene is absolutely spectacular, though. The entire scene just focuses on how Snow White's feeling, down to the music, the animation, everything that's going on around her. And she's pretty scared, so because she's scared, we're all seeing terrifying things around her to try and empathise with her. And it only stops when she just can't take anymore and collapses onto the forest floor. A bunch of animals come and cheer her up, calm her down, take her in, and then they help her find somewhere to stay. The dwarf's cottage. And then she moves in. Pretty basic. But can we just take a moment to appreciate Doc? Now that I'm all grown up, I understand what the writers have been doing with this guy, and I get all the adult jokes that were made.
Careful, man. Search every cook and nanny, hook and granny, crooked fa- search everywhere. Look what's happened to our stable, the table. One of us has got to go down and chase it up. Up.
The guy gets tongue-tied so easily, and it's brilliant because it's a consistent thing. Even when he gets in a fight with Grumpy, the writers never let Doc off. He always gets tongue-tied, and it's brilliant. I just want to applaud them for their marvellous work on writing Doc. Anyway, the Queen turns into an old hag after finding out that the huntsman didn't actually kill Snow White, poisons an apple, makes Snow White eat the apple, and then Snow White goes into a coma that she can only be awoken by
true love's kiss.
The dwarves come home, find Snow White unconscious on the floor, realise that it's a stepmother, go and find her, and she falls off a cliff trying to kill them.
trapped. Oh, what do I do? I'll make her the little fools.
And that was also another scene that terrified me growing up. Another feature you'll hear me talk about when doing this Disney education is the soundtrack. Nothing beats a Disney soundtrack. Nothing. So the Snow White soundtrack was composed by Frank Churchill and the lyrics were written by Larry Morey. And bro, can we just appreciate Someday My Prince Will Come? Adriana Carcelotti was the voice actress for Snow White and also sung for the film, and her voice is just... But let's be real, if you're going to know any song from this film, it's going to be... Which is now featuring Seven Dwarfs Mine Train at Disney World. An awesome ride. If you're going, I would definitely recommend it, fast passing it. The soundtrack to this film was also nominated for a Best Musical Score at the 1938 Academy Awards. But unfortunately, it lost out to 100 Men and a Girl. In my opinion, Snow White should have won, but I'm a bit biased, so. But I took a listen to the winning soundtrack, and it was pretty darn good. And in the 2000s, Disney Toon Studios made an attempt at creating a computer animated prequel to Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs. And they'd be going through the backstory of how the dwarves met, and also how the queen took the throne and killed Snow White's father. But it was a shame, because it would have been interesting to hear the backstories between all the dwarves and the deaths and... everything else. I think I would have liked to have seen that. So that's a brief lesson on Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs. That's by no means everything about the film, because we could just go on for ages if we talked about every single aspect of the film. And that's all from me for now. Thanks for your time, and I'll see you on Friday. Bye!